Champ Car Series leader Paul Tracy goes for a historic 4 in a row, hoping to put some championship luster on a career that's been filled with success and controversy. The big story coming into this weekend.
Paul Tracy.
Brilliant.
Paul Tracy wins.
I was able to pull away whenever I wanted to.
Zipping out of his pimp's glass.
Everything seems to be happening right now.
You know you're living a charmed life. Paul Tracy's perfect 3-for-3 start to the 2003 season is unprecedented in the modern Champ Car era. But it comes as no surprise to those who have followed the career of the Thrill from West Hill, a Toronto suburb where it all began 28 years ago.
I just go out there and I do what I do, and I love to do what I do, and that's race the car. Well, I started very early. I started racing when I was 6. I just had the opportunity to race the Can-Am car for Horse Kroll when I was 17, and I guess that was really my first big thing where people noticed me, was winning the Can-Am race.
In 3 weeks, I'm going to England to do the Grandstand Series with the Van Diemen Factory, and then maybe next year, Formula 3.
In fact, Tracy stayed home that next year, 1988, and won his first start in what would become the Indy Lights Series. 2 years later, he swept 9 races and the title. A year later, the 22-year-old Tracy was a hot commodity. He made his Champ Car debut, then signed with front-running Penske Racing. His first start for the team came at Michigan, where he qualified 8th, but he crashed on lap 3, breaking his left leg.
I thought that was pretty much the end of my career right there.
Far from it, Tracy scored 11 race victories in 5 seasons at Penske. He also spent a year with the Newman Haas team, winning twice more. And a 5-year tenure at Team Cool Green saw still more success, but he failed to claim a championship, and there were whispers. Tracy would win or crash, and he's not a team player.
You don't do that to me or to anybody
on the straight away like that.
Never. I've weathered, I guess, through the storm of racing where I've gotten myself into trouble and problems with the chief stewards and negative attention from the press and negative attention from the fans.
The guy was blocking me the whole way around the track. You're driving like a damn idiot.
When it comes time to come to a race weekend, I'm able to just kind of put the blinkers on and focus on the race weekend.
Between those weekends, Tracy enjoys his toys at home in Las Vegas.
I do have a lot of toys. A lot of them feed my own ego. I like to ride motorcycles. It's a release. You know, the same with having a boat. I mean, go out to the lake and just forget about racing for half a day and not have to talk about racing. I've run with the best in the world, and I've proven that I can run with any of these guys. So, I don't see anybody out there that's mentally or physically a challenge.
Well, Tommy, you know Paul Tracy very well, and you've watched him race for years. As we look at some of his highlights and lowlights from the weekend thus far here at Brands Hatch, what do you think of what he's accomplishing this year?
Well, I mean, Paul Tracy's greatest strength is also his greatest weakness, and anything less than a win is unacceptable to him, and that's led to problems in the past. But as time goes along, I think more people come to appreciate his willingness to fail in pursuit of victory.
No question. With Paul Tracy, what you see is what you get. He's the